the alignment of the strings V and W, in which the V string has the N characters and the W string has the M characters. So the alignment of V and W strings is basically a two rows alignment matrix. In this two row alignment matrix, first row consists of the characters N of the V string, and the second row contains the characters M of the W string. And between these two strings, there may be some spaces that are placed interspersed within the two strings at different places. So as a result, we will get the characters of both of the strings in order. But these may not be necessarily the consecutive, but these characters may be adjacent, but not necessarily be the adjacent. So no column in the alignment also. It means that the both rows should not have the spaces in between when we look up in the column. So no columns in the two rows should have the spaces. So it means that the alignment may have at most n plus m characters in the columns. So the columns that contain the same letter in both rows, as we see here, that we assume that this is the V string and this is the W string, and the V string is A T G T T A T and the W string is A T C G T A C. And we can see here that the columns that contain the same alphabet, they are called the matches, while the columns containing different letters are called mismatches. In these two strings, there is no mismatch here. Again, the column of the alignment containing one space are called indels. So these are called indels spaces. And indel means that, IN means that it is insertion, and the last four words DELS means the deletions. So we combinedly write is as indels, insertion and deletions. So with the column containing a space in the top row called insertions, and we can also categorize these indels into two types: the spaces which are present in the V, they are called insertions, and the spaces that are present in the second row, bottom row, they are called deletions. These are deletions. So in this two row matrix, there are five matches. We can see here, number one is here, number two, second match, third, fourth, and fifth. There are five matches, and there is zero mismatch because there is no mismatch in this matrix. And we have four indels. We have already seen number one, number two, number three, and number four. Four indels in this matrix. So the number of matches plus the number of mismatches and the plus the number of indels should be equal to the length of the alignment matrix and must be smaller than n plus m. So we can see here that each of the two rows in the alignment matrix is represented as a string, as we have seen that these are two strings V and W, and we can say that they are interspersed by spaces, as we have seen earlier that there are spaces, and we can denote these spaces by a dash. For example, AT, this is AT, ANT, GT, this is GNT, and we can see here between ANT and GT, there is a space. So we will designate write it as AT between space and then GT. And then we can see T, AT, T, AT. And again there is a space, so we will write space after T. So this is the representation of the row corresponding to V. And the W we will write here as AT, AT, C, C, GT, GT. Then there is a space, we write here space, then A, space again, and last is C. And this is the representation for the string, that is W. Again, we can write in a different representation to show the alignment of the two strings. So these are the same two strings, V and W. And we can write in the numeric form also. And we have seen that this is the string V. And we can write it as 0. We will start from 0 because in the grid we have to start from 0. Then we have a 1, 2, and we have after T there is a space. So if we want to represent in the numeric form, then if there is a space after any alphabet, we will repeat that number. So this is 2 here, and we will repeat the number 2. Then 3, 4, continuously it is coming, 5, no space, we will continue it, 7, then we will see that there is a space after T, then we will repeat this number 7 again. So the representation of this string will be 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 7 again. So we can write in the numeric form also. Similarly, we can represent the W string as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Because there is space, we will repeat the number 5, 6. Again, space, we will repeat 6, and there is 7. So we will write it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 again, double 6, and 7. And we can also write the mathematical representation of these two strings as in the form of pairs. So we can see here that there are two strings, number 1 and number 1. So we will write this 1 and 1. Definitely there is a 0 before 1 and 1, then 2 and 2, then 2 and 3, 3 and 4, and so on. So if we'll write in this representation, then 0, 0 will be written like this. 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 5, 6, 6, 7, 6, and 7, 7. So there are many different types of representation to represent the two rows matrix analysis. So we cannot compare this also in this form, in a continuous form also, because we have seen this starting from 0, 0. So we will convert this into a pair form to fit it in the grid graph analysis. So 0, 0 will be written as 0, 0. 1, 1 will be 1, 1. 2, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 3, and so on. So we will write it in the pair form also, so that we can use these figures and values while calculating the score in the graph. And these values from 0, 0 to 7, 7, they will be starting from 0, 0 to NM in any of the grid, because NM is the value of these pair form, and we don't know what will be the last value. In this case, NM will be 7 and 7.